Good morning, kids. I'm Miss Bev, and I'm the Children's Ministry Director at Bellevue Christian Church. And we're a church where ordinary kids are learning to live everyday life like Jesus. So before we begin our lesson, go ahead, stand up, and we're going to sing and worship Jesus.
Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Okay, kids, welcome back. It's so good to be back with you this week. The last 2 weeks, we've had guest teachers, and we want to give a great big thanks to Miss Camilla and Miss Carolyn, who taught our lessons the last 2 weeks. So everybody at home, give them a great big round of applause and thank them for filling in and teaching for us. Okay, so kids, today is the last lesson of our Mission Possible series lessons. And we've been talking about a man the past couple weeks. And I believe that man's name was Paul. Do you remember Paul? Yes. Now, Paul had a name before he became Paul. Does anybody remember our very first lesson? What was Paul's name? Do you remember? If you said Saul, you are correct. Saul was a man who did not believe in Jesus. He persecuted and he killed those that did believe in Jesus. And remember, we talked about, here's our map. We talked the very first week how Saul, he was on the road to Damascus. Remember, and a bright light shined in his eyes and he became blind. And he became Paul. So kids, God, he had a mission for Paul. He had something very important for Paul to do. And do you know, kids, that Paul accepted that mission and he helped spread the gospel of Jesus because he accepted his mission from God. Today, we are going to end our series about Paul. And just like Paul, we too have a mission. Do you know, kids, that God, he wants us all to stay focused on his mission to spread the good news about Jesus Christ to everybody we meet. Whether we do it with our words or our actions, we should always keep our eyes on Jesus, and so that we never want to miss a chance to bring glory to his name. Like Paul, who was one of God's most devoted special agents, we can live every moment seeking to bring glory to God. Letting people know that Jesus loves them and that he died for their sins, that's your mission. That's my mission. Stay on track so that one day God will say to you and to me, mission accomplished. Our special agent, Paul, lived in a time when you could go to jail or be killed for believing in Jesus. Can you believe that, kids, that you could go to jail or be killed just by believing or for believing in Jesus? He was thrown in jail many times, and he eventually died believing in Jesus and for his faith. Paul died believing in Jesus. But in today's story, kids, we're going to see just how focused Paul was on his mission. This is a story of the miraculous escape that never happened because Paul refused to run from his mission. Today, kids, we're going to be reading out of the Bible. We're going to be reading out of the book of Acts. We've had this story a couple months ago, and I read it out of the storybook Bible. But today, Miss Bev's going to use her Bible, and we're going to read from the book of Acts, okay? So, let's find the book of Acts. The book of Acts is actually in the New Testament. Remember, we always talk about how the Bible is God's Word. Everything in it is true. There are 66 books in the Bible, and we're going to be reading out of Acts, which is in the New Testament. So, kids, this story actually starts in chapter 16, verse 16 through 34. But Miss Bev is going to start with verse 22. Okay, so you at home, if you want to, parents, grandparents, if you want to read the beginning of the story to your kids, that would be great. But the beginning of the story, kids, talks about a girl who was doing and saying things that did not glorify God. And when Paul and Silas confronted her, this is what happened to Paul and Silas. So let's listen to this story out of the book of Acts, starting with verse 22. Reading through verse 34. Okay, the Bible says that the crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten. After they had been severely flogged, which means they were whipped, they were thrown into prison. And the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. Upon receiving such orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks But let's stop right there for a minute. We talked about how they were severely flogged, and Miss Beth told you that meant that they were whipped, and they were put in prison in something called stocks. Stocks, kids, was two boards that were put together on top of your ankles, and they used clamps and chains to hold them together so that the prisoners could not escape. And this is what happened to Paul and Silas. This is what the jailer did to the men's feet so that they could not leave the prison walls. They put these stocks around their ankles. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Imagine, kids, they're in prison, and Paul and Silas are singing and praising God and praying to him. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prison doors flew open, and everybody's chains came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. You see, kids, the jailer, he was in charge of Paul and Silas, and if Paul and Silas would have escaped, the jailer would have got in a lot of trouble. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself. We are all here." The jailer called for lights, rushed in, and fell trembling before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, "Sir, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, Paul and Silas replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your household." Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all the others in his house. At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Then immediately he and all his family were baptized. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before them. He was filled with joy because he had come to believe in God, he and his whole family. Can you imagine what a mission Paul and Silas were on? You know, kids, Paul would not have been the first man to have a miraculous escape from jail. Earlier in the book of Acts, we see that Peter was set free from prison by an angel, and he was rescued from death. Paul knew that death could have been in his and Silas's immediate future as well. But do you know, kids, that when God knocked on the walls of the prison, they stayed put? Paul and Silas could have run free, but they chose not to. Paul knew that he had a chance to make an impact on that jailer. And because of his faithfulness, the jailer and his family were saved. Some people might think, who really cares about that jailer? He's one of the bad guys, right? Jesus cared about that jailer. He doesn't see good guys and bad guys, sinners and saved. Jesus loves everyone. And he wants all of us to see our friends and our neighbors and our classmates the same. You know, kids, God wants us to focus on Jesus and to serve him at all times so that our lives will bring glory to Christ. Just like Paul and Silas's lives, they brought glory to the name of Jesus. You know, kids, I have a challenge for each one of you to take up this mission possible. I want to challenge each one of you to spend time with God every day. I want you to always be asking God for your orders. Just like Paul and Silas had a mission and they were given orders, I want you to ask God, what are your orders? God will give you the chance to serve him every single day. If your heart is willing and your eyes are open, God will use your life to spread His love and bring glory to His name. God will give you the gifts. He'll give you the courage. He'll give you the wisdom to fulfill the mission that only you can fill. Your orders are waiting to be delivered. You just have to take the first step. God is looking for believers who want to be agents of change, just like Paul and Silas. He wants a church that is filled with Christians who will focus on Christ and serve Him in a fallen world. You know, kids, that's your mission. And I pray that you choose to accept that mission, that you choose to be like Paul and Silas. They could have run away, but Paul knew his mission was to spread the gospel of Jesus to that jailer and to his household. And because of that, the jailer and his household, they were baptized and became believers of Jesus. And that's what I hope and pray for each one of you kids, is that you find people in your life that you can share the gospel of Jesus with. That's your mission. Now, kids, we have a craft today, and I know you don't have the craft at home, but I think you'll be able to do this craft. So if you want to stop the video to get the supplies you need, you can, or you can do it when we're done. You will need some paper, whether it's construction paper, white paper, whatever. Grab some paper. You will need either tape or a stapler. You are going to need a marker or a pen and a pair of scissors, okay? And what you're going to do, kids, we talked about how Paul and Silas were in chains. Well, we're going to make chains today, okay? Our chains aren't going to be exactly like Paul and Silas's, but it's going to be a good reminder of our mission. So what you're going to do, kids, is you're going to take paper, and I want you just to cut strips. You could cut them as long and as wide, as narrow as you want to do that. Just cut some strips, just like Miss Bev is doing, okay? A lot of you have probably made paper chains before. And then what you're going to do, kids, is you're going to make circles with these, okay? Just like this to make a chain. And you can either use scotch tape to hold it together, or you can take a stapler and staple it together, okay? And then we're going to link these together, okay? So we're going to put another one through the first chain and attach it just like that. And you can use lots of different colors if you want. You can make a pattern. You can use all the same color if you would like. Miss Bev likes to use different colors, okay? And we're just going to make a paper chain, just like this, okay? That's our paper chain. Now, what we're going to do with this paper chain, you can either decorate these strips with crayons or markers beforehand, or some of the things that I've already done is this. I have already made two. You can see they're in front of me. This first one I did, I put our memory verse on it. Let's say our memory verse together. I have it written up here also. So let's say our memory verse that we have been studying the past 4 weeks together. The memory verse is, all things are possible with God. And that's found in Mark 10:27. So what Miss Bev did was I wrote each word on a strip of the paper before I stapled it together. I wrote all the words, and then I looped them inside each other, hooked them together just like a chain, and I have my memory verse. That way I can keep this in my room or my kitchen so that I always remember that all things are possible with God. All things, not some things. All things. So you can do that with a memory verse. Or kids, you can make a prayer chain. These are different people that may be in your life. Maybe your mom or your dad, your teacher or a friend. Miss Bev put Mr. Jim, and I put Emily on mine. And these just are people maybe that you're either thankful for or you want to pray for each night. You could make a paper chain with that. Or kids, since it's Thanksgiving this week, maybe parents and kids, you could get together and maybe on your strips of paper, you can write things that you're thankful for and make a paper chain that way with the things that we're thankful for. Kids, there's lots of things you can do with these chains. I just want you to make one or two of these so that you always remember the story of Paul and Silas and how Paul's mission was to spread the gospel and that he was in chains for Christ. And when the chains came apart of from Paul, he could have escaped but chose not to. And these chains that we're going to make represent our mission that we have, just like Paul, to spread the gospel of Jesus. So kids, I hope this week you get together with your families for Thanksgiving and make a chain, whether it's thankful things or a prayer chain or the memory verse, and have fun doing that together, okay? Okay, kids, well, I hope you've enjoyed our last week on Mission Possible with studying about Paul. I hope you have a great week. We start a new series next week, so I hope you will tune in and watch. It starts our Advent. So have a great week, have a great Thanksgiving, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.